Russia, Ukraine, Germany, Britain, Vietnam, the Philippines, Sweden, Pakistan, Japan, and other countries. Just an active part in the conflict, making a great contribution to decorating the conquest wonderfully. Voice of Korea expresses deep thanks to all the contestants who strengthened the ties with the Senate and made a positive contribution to our broadcasting through the contest. The jury examined the answers of the listeners several times. As a result, 3 answers were chosen as excellent ones, 12 as very good ones, and 15 as good ones. Now we'll make public the listeners who sent excellent, very good, and good answers to the Voice of Korea Common Knowledge Contest in 2107 or 2018. Excellent answers came from Zhang Dianzu of China, Andrei Shevelev of Russia, and Vyacheslav Dudalkin of Ukraine. Very good answers came from Han Yuber, Zhang Qi, Sun Xin, and Liu Songye of China, Vladimir Grudenko of Russia, Helmut Mars, Christian Schaffin, Frank Borsonik, Dietmar Watt, and Michel Lodner of Germany, and Hayato Hosawa and Kensuke Tsuruishi of Japan. Good answers came from Sun Weiser, Ye Guangxi, Cheng Jiawei, and Fan Jicheng of China, Marco Reno, Frank Kreitner, Matthias Arndt, and Peter Sommer of Germany, Patrick Travers of Britain, Wenzhen Tai Dan of Vietnam, Robin Spencer of Sweden, Avid Hussain Sajid of Pakistan, and Goji Nakayama, Yukino Mitsubane, and Hinoko Yamazaki of Japan. Voice of Korea decided to award the Labour Prize to Andreas Mitsubane of Germany and Lambert Jamari of France. These are the results of the contest for 2107 or 2018. This year, the listeners took part in the contest more actively than in the previous year. Andreas Mitsubane of Germany and Grant Skinner of Britain sent their answers before others, convincing us of the success in the contest. Then, Zhang Tianzhe, Han Yuber, and Sun Weiser of China, Andrei Shevelev and Vladimir Grudenko of Russia, Marco Reno of Germany, Hayato Hosawa of Japan, and the listeners sent correct and rich answers to the high praise of all the jurors. Especially Vyacheslav Dudalkin of Ukraine, Helmut Matt of Germany, and many other listeners sent good answers along with the pictures concerning the questions, and Tsunoko Yamazaki of Japan, Karsten Schenze of Germany, and others showed uncommon enthusiasm of sending answers and revised answers one after another. Many listeners of China, Germany, and Japan took part in the contest and sent comparatively correct answers to the admiration of the jurors. Many listeners said that through the contest they have a better understanding of Korea. Seeing it was a very significant common knowledge contest, they called for organizing such contests more often. They also expressed the belief that the Korean people would achieve great successes in the building of a proper socialist country in the future, under the guidance of the respective Supreme Leader Kim Jong-un, true to the lofty intention of the great leaders Kim Il-sung and Kim Jong-il. We express the thanks once again to the listeners who made a great contribution to the work of Voice of Korea and further deepened the friendship with the Korean people through the recent Common Knowledge Contest. Believing that the contest has made a great success, we are going to send the prizes to the listeners who sent excellent, very good, and good answers. Souvenirs will be also sent to all other contestants. In the future too, Voice of Korea will organize contests of diverse themes to further strengthen ties with the listeners. We hope those who regret absence from examination for their late participation or the result of the examination would not be disappointed but make greater efforts to be winner in the contest to be held next year. Expressing our thanks to all other listeners of different countries on this occasion, we close the Voice of Korea Common Knowledge Contest for 2107 or 2018. Goodbye.
our regular program, Listener's Mailbag. This is Voice of Korea.
Here is orchestral music, Forest Swing, performed by the National Symphony Orchestra.
Thank you.